Hello and welcome students. How are you all?
I hope you all are fine. Let's begin with today's class. In today's class, we are going to study about chapter number 9, which is Fundamental Rights, Fundamental Duties and Directive Principles of State Policy. So, in our earlier chapter, that is in chapter number 8, we already studied about the features of constitution. We saw what are the basic features of our constitution. We saw about the preamble of the constitution, what are the fundamental rights which are given by the constitution to the citizens of India, right? So in today's chapter, or in this chapter, we will study about the fundamental rights, fundamental duties and the directive principles of state policy. Let's begin with today's class. Introduction. In the previous chapter, we have studied Indian Constitution, preamble and important pillars as well as the specific characteristics. So we already know about the Constitution because we have studied in our previous chapter. In this chapter, we will study about other important characteristics of Constitution, that is fundamental rights, fundamental duties and directive principles of state policy. So we are going to study about the fundamental rights, fundamental duties and the directive principles of state policy. But before starting with the fundamental rights, we'll first study about the human rights. What is the right of a human being, right? So human rights are those rights which not only give a person his or her existence, but also overall development in which society helps to construct an environment which enables him or her to grow. So human rights are those rights which are given to a person for their existence or for their living, but the human rights are also for the development of that person. And the development, why the development of person is needed, because that can help a society to construct an environment where a human being can develop their selves, right? So in every democratic country, the citizens are conferred with basic rights. So the basic rights of the citizens are there in every democratic country, right? So if the country is a democratic country, then it's obvious that the people of that country will have their basic rights. A person is not discriminated, which means that a person is not being treated on the basis of their caste, can experience the basic rights. So this is an example that human rights means there should be no discrimination regarding any caste or any creed, and that is called as the basic right. The protection of these rights are assumed by society and nation as well. So not only the society but the nation is also responsible for this type of human rights. The person by his birth own rights, which are his or her basic rights, which are known as human rights. So a person, when he or she takes birth, he brings their own rights, right? So when a person is born, they get their rights. So that basic rights which a person gets is called as human rights. United Nations General Assembly has declared human rights on 10th of December 1948. And 10th of December is celebrated as Human Rights Day. So the General Assembly of United Nations has declared human right. They declared human right on 10th of December in 1948. And after that, 10th of December is celebrated as Human Rights Day. From the global announcement of human rights, certain basic and important human rights are added in the Constitution of India. So, as this was a very important thing, that a human rights is a very important thing, and thus when our Constitution was
there when our constitution was in the process of making, our constitution assembly added this human rights, some of the human rights and of India, and thereby these rights are protected in a dignified way. And because these rights are added in our constitution, they are protected, and each and every person is treated in very respectful way. Dignified means treating someone in very respectful way. Thus, those human rights which are included by Constitution of India are known as fundamental rights. So the rights which are added in the Constitution on the basis of humans, or human rights which are added in the Constitution, are known as the fundamental rights, which means the basic rights. These human rights proclaim the human being to live in a dignified way. Why are these rights given to the citizens of that particular country? Because so that that person or that human being can live in a very respectful way, right? For the existence of human being, the basic need is food, clothes, shelter, education and health. So these are the basic rights which a human being needs for their existence, should be received in a dignified and respectful way. So every person have this basic fundamental right that he or she should get their food, basic needs, that is food, clothes, shelter, education and health. And this is the reason why the constitution has given this human right, so that every person can get the right to food, clothing, shelter, education and health, right? And that too in a very dignified and respectable way. Democratic country allows its citizen to enjoy equal rights for multifaceted development. So our democratic countries allow its citizens, they give permission to their citizens to enjoy equal rights for multifaceted development, for their development, right? The state guarantees such a conducive environment wherein one has protection of fundamental rights, a truly identity of democratic system. So basically, a state or a country gives the environment so that one has protection to fundamental rights, and they should get a true identity of democratic system, right? So democratic system is basically to give each and every person equal right. Every person should not be discriminated. There should not be any discrimination or any type of partiality. Every person should get their basic necessity like food, clothing, shelter, health, medical help or education and everything, right? So these are the basic, or you can tell these are the fundamental rights which helps a person to know the identity of democratic system. What basically a democratic system is, the people would know that this is the democratic system. What does the democratic system means? That everyone should have an equal opportunity and equal respect, right? So in our next class we will continue the topic, that is fundamental rights, right? So thank you.